Next work in tonight's prom has been commissioned by the BBC and is about to be given its first performance. It is the second piano concerto of Ronald Stevenson, who himself will be playing the piano part. It's subtitled The Continents. Stevenson, who's 44 this year, was born in Blackburn, and he won scholarships to the Royal Manchester College of Music, where he's now a fellow, and to the Conservatorio di Santa Cecilia in Rome. From 1963 to 65, he was senior lecturer in composition at the University of Cape Town, and it was while he was in South Africa that he read a poem which suggested to him the form of this second piano concerto. The poem was The Child, Die Kind, by an Afrikaans poet, Ingrid Jonker. Stevenson explains it as follows. The black child, with a bullet through his brain in Sharpeville, only wanted to play in the sun. As a symbol, he will grow into a man who will trek through Africa, a giant who will travel through the world without a passbook. As a result of his reading this poem, the concerto became a trek through the music of the continents, with all the struggle of a piano pitted against an orchestra. The work is in five sections with a prologue and an epilogue, and it's played without a break. Each section is based primarily on one element of music and scored predominantly for one particular department of the orchestra. The first section, after the prologue, is concerned with Africa. It's exclusively rhythmic, and it's scored for percussion only, including the strings of the piano being drummed by the pianist's hand. The second section, Australasia and Asia, consists mainly of pentatonic melody, unharmonized or with a drone bass, chiefly for the strings of the orchestra. The strings of the piano are also used for pizzicato effects. Then from single line melody, the work ramifies into the polyphony of fugue. The next two sections are both fugues, scored mainly for woodwind and piano. The first, developing material from the prologue, is West European in type. The second is cast in East European dance rhythms. And here the piano part is a moto perpetuo, and the section culminates in a fanfare for brass and a Russian-type march for full orchestra. A transition leads to the final section, a tribute to America and Latin America, which deploys the orchestra more freely, with the brass to the fore. And much of this material is pentatonic, which relates it to the Asian section. Eventually, the musics of different continents confront one another, and the piano hammers out a reiterated chord as if to assert human rights. The epilogue which follows is a reminiscence of the prologue, a question, yet with hope. Ronald Stevenson says that he's remembered the words of Paul Robeson, there are many nations, but there's only one race, the human race. And he says that there are many different sorts of music. They are all united in voicing humanity. The composer, Ronald Stevenson, is on the platform now. So is Norman DelMar. The Continents.
Thank you. Thank you.
to continents. Ronald Stevenson's second piano concerto has just been given its first performance by the New Philharmonic Orchestra leader Desmond Bradley, conducted by Norman DelMar. And the piano was played by the composer himself, Ronald Stevenson. Well, that brings us to the interval at the Royal Albert Hall. Paul Stevenson escaped them. They've brought him back and he's taking yet another bow after his performance of his work, The Continents. Now he leaves the stage and I return you to Broadcasting House.